After 15 years of research, an astronomer from the Dunlap Institute has cracked the code in what could possibly be a culmination of a study that began in the 1960s. In her analysis, Dr. Jennifer West, a research associate at the Institute, boldly proposes a massive magnetic tunnel surrounding the solar system. Further, she posits a connection between the two bright structures that are seen on opposite sides of the sky. It is from this connection that the magnetic tunnel in radio waves emanates. This is a departure from the previous position that considered these structures as separate entities with no relation. Importantly, what is the idea behind this, and does it have any merit? It is an open secret that before Dr. Jennifer's proposals, a number of scientists with interest in this had also tried to study the tunnels. However, it was impossible to find out their exact nature and location because of either the crude data that was previously used or the exclusive study of these structures as separate entities. The years that preceded this saw an explosion in the study of radio astronomy, and the result was various very powerful telescopes that scan the sky constantly. And it is in this golden age of radio astronomy that it became possible to unravel a lot of mysteries that lie in the sky. Basing her argument on the hypothesis of the two structures in the sky, the fan region and the North Polar Spur, University of Toronto astronomer Jennifer West proposed the new solar system model, which has a magnetic tunnel all around it. The North Polar Spur is a large body that emits hot radio and X-ray gas that then rises above the galaxy's plane. It is found approximately 500 light years away from us, and its origin, like that of many different formations, is still unknown. When observed closely, it looks as a vast yellow cloud that spreads from Sagittarius through Scorpius, Lupus, and beyond Centaurus. The fan region, which is polarized radiation, is located to the west. To find a link between the North Polar Spur and the fan region, the University of Toronto researchers had to modify their viewing point to make the radio signals appear to be originating from inside the galaxy's local arm. By altering the shape and location of these filaments, connecting the North Pole Spur and the fan region, the team constructed a computer model that projected a map of the sky when viewed in the radio region. According to new research, the magnetic tunnel that surrounds the Earth's solar system comprises charged particles and spans 1,000 light years in length with a distance of 350 light years. To further explain this concept and how it inspired the idea to remake the map, Dr. Jennifer uses the map of Earth as an example. As is known, the North Pole is found at the top, while the equator runs through the middle. She suggests there can be a reimagination of this map with a different perspective, and this holds for our galaxy too. Scientists are still unsure how magnetism works on a cosmic scale, with electrons functioning as the medium, but this new research employing the magnetic filament theory may help them comprehend it. The researchers are currently planning a follow-up investigation to determine how to use the filaments in a galactic field model. Obviously, this is only a preliminary study that needs to be confirmed by other scientists, but it appears to be extremely promising at the moment. Dr. Jennifer's paper has received a lot of favorable feedback so far, and many academics are shocked by this result. More significantly, a far better depiction and simulation of what's happening here, based on the modeling techniques employed and a little bit more information and data to work with, would be extremely useful. So, once we have more comprehensive maps and models, we should have a better idea of what is occurring with this magnetic tunnel that we appear to be flying through in the next years. If you like this video, please consider subscribing and click the notification bell so you do not miss any upcoming videos.